Breaking news about a Cincinnati giant. We're told Carl Lindner Jr. is gravely ill at Christ Hospital. Doctors tell us the 92-year-old tycoon and philanthropist has been suffering from heart problems. Our crews have been monitoring his condition all night.
And NewsWise Terry Daniels is live at Christ Hospital right now with the very latest and an update on his condition. Terry?
Sure, I can tell you Carl Lindner Jr. is here at Christ Hospital, although because of HIPAA laws, they're being very tight-lipped about his exact condition. We do know he was actually transferred here from Jewish Hospital in Kenwood. That's where he was taken early this morning. Now, according to emergency personnel in Indian Hill, medical and fire staffers were called to Mr. Lindner's home on Shawnee Run Road about 3:30 this morning. Now, according to a 911 call obtained by News 5, someone at the house said Mr. Lindner had very shallow breath and a weak pulse. He does have a pacemaker implanted in his chest to deal with heart issues. Sources tell us he actually had to be resuscitated at one point. We are also told that family members have been notified, and in fact, some of them are flying in from around the country. Again, at this point, 92-year-old Carl Lindner here at Christ Hospital, gravely ill. Reporting live, Terry Daniels, News 5.
Terry, thank you. And you know, it really seems there's hardly a big business or a charity here in the tri-state that Mr. Lindner hasn't touched.
And his best-known businesses don't just rise up to the sky, they bring smiles to every local neighborhood. Most recently, our city's most prominent citizen added the crown jewel to the Cincinnati skyline, the Great American Tower.
It will show that Cincinnati's the kind of place that many other Fortune 500 companies ought to check out.
But on a more modest scale, Carl Lindner Jr. became a fixture in pretty much every tri-state neighborhood with more than 200 United Dairy Farmer stores. His own beginnings couldn't have been more modest. Born in 1919, 14-year-old Carl had to drop out of school to help run his family's ice cream store in Norwood when his dad became ill. The young man who made pre-dawn milk runs went on to become one of the richest men in the world, with business assets that he reckoned were worth $14 billion. They included, at various times, United Dairy Farmers, Great American Insurance Company, Chiquita Bananas, the Cincinnati Enquirer, and the Cincinnati Reds that he bought from Marge Schott.
So this is just a little token from...
Get a load of this. It's a star. From another star. Thank you, honey. I appreciate it. Thank you, honey.
Lindner's support for the Republican Party became most visible in 2004 when he invited President George W. Bush to Great American Ballpark for a campaign rally. But he was usually a very shy man, a devout Baptist who didn't smoke, drink, or swear. Mr. Lindner founded Cincinnati Hills Christian Academy, but instead of answering reporters' questions about that or anything else, he handed out little white cards that said things like, "I like to do my giving while I'm living, so I'm knowing where it's going." And give, he and his family did, donating $60 million in just one 10-year period. Everything from the Lindner Family Tennis Center in Mason to the Lindner Center of Hope, a treatment center for people with mental health problems.
Shy as he's been, Carl Lindner Jr. has known presidents, superstar ball players, and folks, he's always been surprisingly kind to all around town.
News 5's Laura Borchers has reaction for us tonight. Laura?
Jack and Sheree, tonight I've talked with more than a dozen people who knew Carl Lindner Jr. very well. Each of them have a story to tell about his business savvy and his generous gestures. Each of them praying for his family members right now. Those family members are with him at Christ Hospital. That's a hospital that has an entire heart center named after him. Cincinnati's most influential resident is a billionaire with many causes, including the Lindner Family Center, the Lindner Center for Hope. Staff there says simply, quote, "Our thoughts are with the family." Tonight, former Cincinnati Mayor Charlie Lukin shared several stories of moments he shared with his friend.
I was the mayor in the 80s, and Carl would, he just loved Cincinnati at that point. And he was just starting to enjoy the fruits of his success, and he was just the most devoted, kind guy and advisor. He did more things in the city than any mayor or 10 mayors will ever do.
Anytime the tournament needed something, whether we wanted to expand the facility or needed you know, more tickets to be sold or whatever, Carl was always the first one in line to stand up and help us. And the tournament would not be where it is today without his support.
Elaine runs the Western Southern Open. That, of course, is the hub of the Masters each year held at, of course, the Lindner Family Tennis Center. This is a man who's very well linked to every part of Cincinnati. And right now we're standing in front of a UDF here in Clifton. We also visited the UDF in Norwood, which was the very first one that he and his family opened. Even the store clerks there tell us they are praying for his family members tonight. Reporting live, I'm Laura Borchers, News 5.